think we all have times in our life that things that happen haunt us and stay with us. And that's part of what makes us human. And that's, you know, everybody has some rain in their lives.
When you're in Act Four, does Tucker know what he's going to do?
I think the way I've interpreted it is when I'm in Act One, I know what I'm going to do. Could three suicides happen in a week? Absolutely. Can shedding light on this situation help? Absolutely. You know, I really haven't had time to really think about the romantic side of, you know, Olivia Benson and Ed Tucker, in as much as they have both moved on. And Ed's experience has been radically different than hers. She stayed on the job. He's retiring. She's healthy. He's sick. This is life. This is the way it goes, especially in the police department, law enforcement. I do understand your point and accept your point about, you know, maybe there's a lot crammed in, but at the same time, I asked myself, could it happen? And the fact of the matter is, yes, it could. And it, you know, in that cluster situation we've talked about.
Yeah, and one of the things that we wanted to echo in the script is the sense of the history of the relationship between Tucker.
Which I think is beautifully done. Yeah,
yeah.
That's interesting to me that you're saying in Act One, you know what you're going to do.
I believe so. You know,
do you see it that way?
He's the man. He's the captain of the role.
Contemplation of it. There's a scene where I say, I just was told 6 months to a year. You know what I mean? And I'm not going to put my wife through this. I'm just, you know, as honorably as I can possibly be to myself and others. But it's just a very, you know, it's an existential question, obviously. But at the same time, you know, those are private things the actor figures out for himself. But again, going back to Mariska, is I've always just enjoyed acting with her. She's a rush to act with. She's 110% there all the time. She's constantly trying to make it better. And that's been enjoyable over these years, you know, our arc of the relationship.
Obviously, you were not a well-liked character in your initial time here. And then you had this long romance. When you look back on it, what's the memories you have of that period?
Well, playing the bad guy is always so much more fun. you know, the writing was always such that it was very concise. You know, the perception here is one of your detectives has done something wrong and I'm here to investigate it. And if you have a problem with, you know, dirty cops being investigated, well, then you have a problem. But I just really enjoyed playing this guy. I enjoyed, you know, like people randomly in New York telling me, yo, leave my Olivia alone, you know? And I was like, I'm doing my job well. And, you know, back to the days of Chris Maloney and everything. And, you know, he's such a powerful guy and a powerful character. And to have to go up against him. And it was wonderful as an actor. It's, you can't ask for more of that kind of, you know, head-to-head conflict. And again, always perfectly, as far as I was concerned, written. And then when Mariska said to me a couple of years ago, you're going to be my love interest, I think I said something like, that's going to be a slow boat to turn around. and I said, that won't work. And she said, no, it will work. And the writers and the producers, they made it work very subtly. And then there's life. She was determined to keep her job. She was at the top of her game. She was being, you know, a new mom. Did she have time for this guy? No, was the answer. You know, and I thought it was very wise, that character, to say, you know what? I'm just going to keep this simple. We're going to let this go right in. That's life. That's a very educated adult decision that she came to. It was at my, you know, expense. But at the same time, listen, I had just the greatest time.